So it turns out that once you look at this limit definition of derivatives, that there are some derivatives which pop up or are pieces to other derivatives over and over again. And as you can imagine, using the limit definition gets old after a while. It gets kind of very long and involved, and there's a lot of algebra, you can make mistakes. Okay, so we want to talk about several different shortcuts for derivatives that we will use extensively in this class. So these are shortcuts, right? Okay, and the first is for f of x is equal to a constant. Now I'm just going to write out here the example f of x is equal to the constant function 5. Now, when we think back to how the derivative, where it comes from, it comes again originally from the idea of slope, right? And this is the equation of a line that's a horizontal line, right? Y is equal to 5 is the exact same line that I have. That's a horizontal line, and we remember that the slope of this line is 0, right? When I measure the change in y in the numerator, nothing about y is changing, but if I use two different x values, then that will change and I get slope of 0. So we expect and we see that when you take and use this limit definition of the derivative for any constant function, f prime of x is 0, that there's no change happening in this function. Okay? So that's one of these shortcuts that I'm going to remember. The second that I'm going to use is for polynomial or monomial functions. F of x is equal to x to the nth power. Okay? And it turns out, and I want to use this for, we've been doing a lot of functions like f of x equals x and x squared. When you compute this limit definition of the derivative for these particular functions, n can be any real number. So fractional powers, which will bring in my rationals. F prime of x is equal to n times x, and I decrease this power by 1. Okay? So I want to go ahead and use this second rule just so that you can see what I'm doing. Example, find f prime for f of x is equal to x to the 7th power. Okay? Here, this 7 is my n right there. Okay? So, and I know from this shortcut, f prime of x is equal to n x to the n minus 1. So I'm going to put in, because I know my n is 7, 7 x and 7 minus 1, I get this 7x to the 6th power. So in a lot of ways, I visualize this as this power, let me rewrite this x to the 7th over here. I visualize this as this x to the 7th power moving out here and becoming a 7x, and then I subtract 1 after I move it, and I get a 6 here. That's what's going on inside my head. I'm not really over and over again kind of figuring out what n is and plugging in. I am kind of moving these pieces around and figuring out what this is. Okay? So let's do this maybe another example. I want to use this same one just to find. So for a simpler function, f of x is equal to x, find f prime of x. Okay, so when I go through and do this, let's see. In this case, my n right here is equal to 1, not 0. I'm circling what that is, I'm sorry. But that should be the number one, right? When we don't have an exponent, it's the number one. So when I take the derivative of x, I move, I get n x to the n minus 1, so I get 1 x to the 1 minus 1, 1 x to the 0. Anything to the 0 power is 1. So I get 1 times 1 should be the number 1. Okay? Okay, let's do one more example like this with fractional powers or with radicals. So 4 f of x is equal to the fifth root of x squared. Find f prime of x. Okay, and here's where I remember that radicals and nth roots are related to exponents, which is good because I only know a rule for x to the n, right? I don't have any rules for exponents. I certainly don't want to be using the limit definition of the derivative for this thing, right? So I'm going to rewrite this as f of x is equal to, and this is x to the 2/5 power, if you remember my rational exponents. So in this case, n is 2/5. Okay, so f prime of x is equal to 2/5 x to the n minus 1 up here, right? N minus 1. So that is 2/5 minus 1. This is 2/5 x, and 2/5 minus 1 is a minus 3/5. Okay? Now, I probably won't leave it like this. I don't like to have negative exponents. So I'll probably rewrite this, maybe even in radical notation, depending on the problem. This is 2/5 x to the negative 3/5. Should be in the denominator, right? So I want to move that down there. Negative, oh, this now is positive when I move it to the denominator, but I get a positive 3/5. So I get 2 over 5, the fifth root of x cubed is what this really looks like, is the derivative of this original function. And this tells me how the function is changing. Okay? Okay, so I want to cover a couple more shortcuts in the next video, and then we'll talk about applications and interpretations of this.